He's a phenomenon in the music industry. R. Kelly, as famous to his generation as the Beatles were to theirs. But the man who sold 30 million records, earned 3 Grammys, and topped the music charts all summer is shadowed by the most shameful criminal charges. 14 counts of child pornography stemming from that infamous sex tape in which prosecutors say he stars. But is there something more to the story? Here's Jay Shadler with an exclusive interview.
R. Kelly is a one-man odd couple, selling both love and lust to a catchy groove. He's a brilliant musician and self-proclaimed Christian who penned one of the great anthems of his generation.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day.
But he's also the author of Bump and Grind and a defendant in a criminal case charging him with child pornography. Kelly has denied the charges and is awaiting trial.
Man, this is simple, man. You know, I'm a good person, man. I love people. People need to understand that R. Kelly is not who they think, but it's who I know, you know? I'm not perfect. I'm not some Jesus that people should worship, but I am not no demon, I'm no devil, I'm no criminal.
Do you consider yourself conflicted at all about these two personas, this incredibly sexual presence on stage, and this desire to be an upright Christian man? That's quite a cavern you're trying to straddle.
Well, being a Christian doesn't necessarily mean you're this upright person. Being a Christian is someone who's repented for their sins and said, God, forgive me.
Sure.
And when you say it today, doesn't mean you can't say it tomorrow. And that's why God is who he is.
But that can get to be an easy way out after a while, because all you're saying is, hey, forgive me again.
Well, that's not all you're saying. You're continuing to pray. You're continuing to gain strength. It's like walking into a health club, man, and you like 600 pounds, you know, as you got a long way to go.
I can feel it. I'm the world's greatest. Whoa.
Kelly's mix of gospel and bordello has deep roots in rhythm and blues, but he's given it his own urban spin.
I'm about to take my key and stick it in the ignition, so give me that.
He was really one of the first R&B artists to be able to compete in the world of hip-hop, to be able to be as cool as the rappers, as tough as the rappers, as interesting as the rappers.
Khalifa Sane is a music critic with the New York Times.
I think when you listen to R. Kelly's music over and over again, one of the things you do hear is obsession and this idea of, I know I shouldn't be doing this, but I kind of really want to. You know, as he sings, my mind's telling me no, but my body's telling me yeah.
Robert Kelly was born on the south side of Chicago, abandoned by his father and raised by a single mom. Joanne Kelly died in 1993, just after her son's first record hit the charts. But she is undeniably alive in his memory.
And we'd go to McDonald's almost every morning. She'd fix a cup of coffee, she'd wear this cheap lipstick. She'd leave this red lipstick ring around my cup, and I'd turn that around and drink from that part, taste lipstick and coffee at the same time, because if I could, I would have married my mom. But you know, she turned me down and it wasn't happening. So I accepted that. But those are the things that my mother and I would share.
When Kelly was a young boy, he loved basketball and music. By the time he was 8, he and his mom were singing songs for loose change on the old L, Chicago's famed commuter rails.
What are some of your first musical memories, Robert?
Slowing up the record, putting a nickel on a needle, and my mom would have me studying Stevie Wonder, you know, a riff.
Wait a minute, you put the nickel on the needle to slow down the record.
So the runs could go really slow, and then you can learn them. And then you learn them and you get it down pat.
With his mom's help, he used that old nickel trick to learn Stevie Wonder's Jammin'.
We'll be jammin' until the break of dawn.
She said, once you learn this jammin', this little riff right here, you know, you can learn anything. And there's a part that goes in his song called, it's the peak of the song, and it goes, oh, I bet you if someone approached you yesterday to tell you that you would be jammin', you would not believe it because you never thought that you would be jammin'.
Oh,
and it's really fast the way Stevie does it. So once I got that, I was like, oh, man.
In 1984, Kelly won his first talent contest, but perhaps more importantly, got his first intoxicating dose of adulation.
And then when I opened my mouth, oh, so long for this night I prayed. As soon as I said that, the crowd went up. You know, high school kids, it's like, if you got a little bit of talent to them, it's like, wow. Girls were screaming, guys was woo, woo, woo. And I won, you know, and right there was like Peter Pan being bit by the spider. You know, he became Spider-Man. So I was like, wow, I don't get this kind of love on a basketball court. I got to be honest with myself, so.
By the early 90s, word of Kelly's remarkable talents had reached music executives in New York, and his career took off.
See, I know there's somebody breaking out the champagne.
Not only was he winning awards and writing his own hits,
never thought that love could be so kind.
But mainstream artists like Celine Dion would vying for his golden touch as a record producer.
I am your angel, your angel.
In 1994, he fell in love with an aspiring singer named Aaliyah.
I don't mean to be bold, but I gotta let you know Aaliyah's got a thing for you, and I can't let go.
But there was a problem. Kelly was 27, and Aaliyah was 15. Their marriage certificate falsely shows her age as 18.
You loved her?
Yeah.
Yeah. Are you uncomfortable talking about her?
Not really uncomfortable, but just very respectful.
That part of the story is of interest because first indication that Robert Kelly might be interested in very young women.
Mm-hmm.
That's why
well,
that's
of interest.
Depends
on who's interested in that story.
Of course, a lot of people were interested in that story, especially when word broke that the two had secretly married.
You tried to hide that at some point, that you didn't get married, but you
no,
did, right?
I vowed that I would not even discuss any of the past, any negative things about Aaliyah. So my memories of Aaliyah
but that's not a negative thing, though, that you loved her, is it?
Oh, I already said I loved her.
In 2001, Aaliyah was killed in a plane crash. Her funeral procession included a horse-drawn carriage and a white coffin. Even though Aaliyah and Kelly's marriage had been annulled years earlier by her parents, her death rekindled questions about Kelly's possible relationships with teenage girls.
Do you think that it is immoral for an older man to have sex with an underage girl?
Rephrase the question.
For an older man
mm-hmm.
to have sex with an underage girl, someone under 17,
mm-hmm.
do you view that as an immoral thing, if they're in love?
If they're in love, I really can't be the judge of that.
This is a girl of my fantasy.
But judging R. Kelly became a pastime in Chicago as rumors of his fascination with underage girls continued to spread.
When this controversy started, people who'd been following R. Kelly's career weren't saying, I never would have expected R. Kelly. I mean, there was some notion that this wasn't a complete surprise. And again, some people chose to believe it, some people chose to ignore it.
But the rumors could no longer be ignored after this videotape surfaced. The videotape allegedly shows Kelly having sex with a 14-year-old girl and is considered to be the centerpiece in a criminal case in which Kelly is charged with 14 counts of child pornography.
Well, last count I had, I think, was maybe 6 or 7 lawsuits filed by various women mm-hmm. against you.
When there's blood in the water, here comes the sharks.
If a concert hall can be acoustically tuned, if a 60,000-seat stadium can have a retractable roof, if an 80-ton bullet train can glide on air, why not your SUV? At GMC, our engineers don't just ask questions, they have answers. The GMC Envoy line of SUVs, professional-grade engineering. It's not more than you need, just more than you're used to.
What'd you have for dinner?
Pound and a half of barbecued chicken, boneless pork ribs, mashed potatoes. You?
Piece of quiche, sprouts, and a side salad.
Blow out the candles. Whoa!
Quiche.
Should have had a Hungry Man XXL, an extra large portion of the food men love. Hungry Man XXL, it's good to be full.
Sunday, Desperate Housewives is TV's best new series. The season's must-see guilty pleasure.
Come on, come on, come on.
It's wonderful, spectacular.
Out the window.
And a hoot.
Hi, honey, you're home early.
Desperate Housewives is TV bliss.
Oh!
This could well be ABC's new water cooler show.
Leave my mommy alone!
The dirty laundry just keeps getting dirtier.
How much do we really want to know about our neighbors?
All new Desperate Housewives, Sunday 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
Music superstar R. Kelly and the notorious sex tape that could send him to prison for 51 years. His life and his defense in his own words. Primetime Live returns after this from our ABC stations.
It's the story of two best friends and the grill that came between them.
Ooh, you want some ointment for that burn?
The stakes are high.
What do you want from me?
The grill brought to my door.
And the temperature's even higher.
And a pie.
Oh, come on. Who's the bigger man?
Now, only one of them will end up with a license to grill on a sizzling new According to James.
Ooh, how delicious.
Tuesday at 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
Advantage Andy.
Wednesday.
What is it?
Stranded on a dangerous island.
Run!
Don't love me!
With no hope for rescue.
It's been 4 days. No one's come.
The struggle for survival begins.
There is no food, dude.
Oh, perfect!
Who is this guy?
Shh. Now's the time to get lost. In the best new drama on TV.
Somebody died out there.
An all-new Lost. Wednesday, 8, 7 Central. Only on ABC. Primetime Live returns with Chris Cuomo.
We continue our look at Jay Shadler's exclusive interview with R. Kelly, the only one since he was charged with crimes that could send him to prison for 51 years.
I was in a cab on the way over here, and the cab driver, I said, I'm doing an interview with R. Kelly. And he said, oh, I've seen him on television.
Mm-hmm.
I like that music. Pause. And then he said, something about child pornography with that guy.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I gotta look at that like I look at everything else. When people say things about you, when people down you, which I've been down for my lyrics in this business.
Tickling and teasing, doing that little dance. Girl, you gonna make me lay you down and give it to you one more dance.
Sexual movements on stage.
Sure.
I've been down for a lot of stuff. And when you become famous, unfortunately, life becomes a stage. You know, and so you have to be this perfect person, which I can't do it.
Of course, the issues shadowing Mr. Kelly are not about perfection, but criminality. In February of 2002, a reporter for the Chicago Sun-Times received an anonymous phone call directing him to go to his mailbox. In it was a 27-minute videotape allegedly showing Kelly having sex with a 14-year-old girl. Though the actual identities of the man and girl on the tape are still a matter of dispute, the state of Illinois was confident enough in this piece of evidence to charge Kelly in the spring of 2002 with child pornography.
The Honorable County Judge Carla Fleming, right presiding, be seated, court is not called to order.
At the time of the indictment, Kelly was at his second home in Davenport, Florida, near Orlando. where he was arrested, spent a night in a Florida jail, and was then returned to Illinois. Arriving back in Chicago, Kelly went straight to the Cook County Criminal Court to turn himself in. But even before he got to the front door, he was abruptly pulled aside, arrested again, and read his rights.
Do you understand that anything you say can and may be used against you?
He knows that I'm his lawyer. He's not going to make any statements.
You understand that you have the right to talk to an attorney before we ask you any questions. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Within hours, the three-time Grammy Award winner had 21 counts of child pornography charges on his resume. He pled not guilty to all of them.
I'm just looking forward to my day in court.
Significantly, he could not be charged with statutory rape because the young girl the police believe is in the video has repeatedly denied that it's her. What's more, although the state of Florida also filed child pornography charges against Kelly, those charges have all been dismissed, and the Illinois charges have since been narrowed to 14 counts. Still, a conviction on any one count could put R. Kelly in prison for at least 6 years. If he's convicted on all counts, the maximum would be 51 years. In addition, there's been a handful of civil lawsuits by women against Kelly.
You've settled some of these lawsuits out of court, right?
Can't talk about it.
Even the ones that are not in trial anymore, not in litigation?
I can't talk about anything pertaining to me and lawsuits and things like that.
Let me ask you a question just more broadly then. Last count I had, I think, was maybe 6 or 7 lawsuits filed by various women against you. A shred of truth in any of them, as far as you're concerned? Any of the allegations?
The only thing I can say about that is the sharks. When there's blood in the water, here comes the sharks.
Kelly says the lawsuits are about money and fantasies. People who want his money and people who believe his music fantasies.
There's so much that people don't know about Robert. They don't know Robert. They see this guy popping Cristal in a video with a nice suit on and diamonds everywhere. He got women around him every day, 24 hours a day. But when you do it on a video and it's ran 20 million times a day, all day long, people, they're forced to have this impression of you, and you can't blame them.
Do you feel like you're paying a price for this persona that you created, this image that you created?
Yes.
Hell yes was going to be the answer.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah.
I'm trying to contain myself.
I know you are.
I created my music, and I did videos, and the video has to make sense. If it's a bump and grind video, then it's going to be a bump and grind song. If it's an I Believe I Can Fly song,
I believe I can fly.
It's gonna be somewhere in the cornfield with pretty beautiful eagles and things like that. I think people should think the same thing when they go to the movies and they see Arnold Schwarzenegger cut somebody's head off or chop somebody's head off or shoot somebody 20 times in the chest. That's a movie, it's entertainment. I entertain. That doesn't mean he's gonna come out of the movie and go do that to somebody. This all entertainment.
But with all respect, I mean, Arnold Schwarzenegger is not charged with child pornography.
But he could be, and he could be charged with anything. It still doesn't matter.
I'm that star up in the sky. I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it. I'm the world's greatest.
Curiously, all of the allegations and lawsuits have not dented Mr. Kelly's popularity. He's still making hit songs, still selling millions of records.
And no one more important to me.
But even R. Kelly would be the first to admit that his is a cautionary tale about success that arrives too early and wisdom a little too late. As we ended the interview, I played him a song he'd written about the old days, back in his Chicago neighborhood, before his mom died. And before his image was born.
We do. Now I'm just missing you. How I wish. I wish that I could hold you now. Oh, I wish that I could touch you now. Oh, I wish that